Congratulations on getting your first C# program up and running. Nice work. Now, before we go any further, let's look at how other C# programs are created. So first we start off with an editor called an IDE. It's otherwise known as an integrated developer environment. In our case, this is Visual Studio. The IDE is a supercharged text editor designed for writing programs, although you could just use a regular plain old text editor if you wanted to. Most people use Visual Studio, which is Microsoft's premier IDE. When you write your program, you can use code from other C# libraries developed by Microsoft. This is the .NET library, and it adds a ton of capabilities to your program. You can create user interfaces in Windows, read and write files over the internet, and even have the computer talk to the end user. .NET provides a ton of features, with new features being added with each release. Once you have your program written in C#, you then run it through a program called a compiler. This compiler takes C# and converts it to another language called intermediate language. This is a language that you can still kind of read, but it's designed specifically for computers. This intermediate language makes it portable across various different platforms. Now, when C# was released, this didn't really matter so much. There was only one platform, but these days you can find various implementations across a variety of different platforms. Okay, so the resulting program from the compiler is called an assembly. Now you can either designate your assembly to be a dynamically linked library, or DLL, or an executable. The dynamic linked library can only be read by other programs, whereas the executable can only be run by the end user. Writing good C# programs means understanding how C# works. Hopefully this video gave you a good overview of that. If you did find it useful, definitely hit that like button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.